John's Manville Spiracoustic Plus Round Duct Liner Insulation is a unique alternative to traditional double wall insulation. It removes the need for an interior perforated core and arrives pre-curved on the job site, ready to fabricate and install. Since the inner metal core is unnecessary with John's Manville Spiracoustic Plus, contractors can fabricate and install the insulation in the shop or in the field. This insulation offers exceptional thermal and acoustical control, and in many jobs, it can reduce the weight of the system while saving time during fabrication and installation. Additionally, by eliminating the need for a perforated metal inner core, you can cut metal fabrication time and metal costs by up to 50%. In this video, we will outline how to install John's Manville's Spiracoustic Plus in a number of different applications, including straight runs, elbows, reducers, and tees. Prior to beginning the installation, ensure that you are wearing all the necessary personal protective equipment, PPE. This includes gloves and safety glasses. You may also use a dust mask if desired, but it is not necessary. For each of the following installation methods, you will need a ductboard knife, a measuring tape, a straight edge, a squeegee, UL-181A approved tape, and something to mark the material, like a white pencil or a piece of chalk. Be careful when using a ductboard knife, as the sharp edge can easily cause injuries. Since Spiracoustic Plus is designed to maintain self-applied pressure, most applications don't require mechanical fasteners. However, for applications where the diameter of the spiral pipe is greater than 60 inches across, mechanical fasteners should be used to ensure the insulation remains in place. The first installation technique we will discuss is how to install Spiracoustic Plus in a straight spiral duct. First, ensure that you have a clean and dry work surface. Also note that for each Spiracoustic Plus fitting, you will want to reduce the circumferential measurement of the duct by approximately 3/4 of an inch when you measure and cut the insulation. This will ensure that the Spiracoustic Plus fits snugly inside the duct or fitting. In order to install Spiracoustic Plus in a straight run, first calculate the circumference of the pipe by multiplying pi times the diameter. Measure and cut the insulation lengthwise to approximately 3/4 of an inch less than the exact circumference of the duct. Roll the section, secure the butt edges with tape crosstabs, and finish by securing the seam longitudinally from end to end with a UL-181A approved closure tape. Run the squeegee firmly along the tape until you can see the scrim pattern through the tape. Then, buckle the liner into a heart shape, ensuring the buckled crease is not at the butt seam, and insert it into the duct. When you release the insulation, it will snap into place, fitting securely inside the duct. Next, let's look at what it takes to fabricate Spiracoustic Plus for an elbow. You will need locking pliers and draw bands shaped as gore patterns in addition to the standard installation materials previously mentioned. First, calculate the circumference of the pipe by multiplying pi times the diameter. Then measure and cut the length of the Spiracoustic Plus to 3/4 of an inch less than the circumference. From there, roll and tape the insulation as you would for a straight section of duct. Once that's complete, clamp the end gore band around the end of the insulation. Ensure that the clamp of the gore band is not aligned with the seam of the Spiracoustic Plus material. Then mark the seam where you clamp the band. You will use this mark to ensure that the Spiracoustic Plus is exactly where it needs to be within the elbow. Using the edge of the band as a guide, cut all the way around the Spiracoustic Plus, following the contour of the draw band. If the cut is square to the draw band, then there will be gaps between the gore pieces. When your cut is complete, remove the band. Repeat this process with the subsequent sections of the gore band. Once you are done, you will have several sections of Spiracoustic Plus that fit together in the shape of an elbow. Now take the piece that will fit in the middle of the duct and buckle it into a heart shape. Slide the Spiracoustic Plus into the middle of the duct, ensuring that the seam where you clamped the gore band is in line with the seam of the duct. Release the insulation and allow it to expand into place. If you are using very small diameter or VSD duct, then do not buckle the insulation prior to insertion. Simply slide it into place. When this piece is snugly in place, you can work your way outward to the next two pieces, and finally, to the end pieces, using the same insertion method for each piece. If there are any gaps in between the insulation sections, fill them with Johns Manville Super Seal sealant. Next, we'll look at how to insulate a reducer. When working with Spiracoustic Plus, it is important to use reducers with a taper length of at least 12 inches. Measure the circumference of both ends of the reducer. Then cut the Spiracoustic Plus using the circumference of the larger end of the reducer. Using the reducer again, measure the height of the taper from the seam at the narrow end to the edge of the large end. Add approximately 4 to 5 inches to that total, and then measure that distance across the width of the Spiracoustic Plus. Make your cut down the length of the Spiracoustic Plus from end to end. Keep the extra piece of insulation handy. We'll use that later. Now, take the reducer and measure the distance of the taper from the seam at the narrow end to the seam at the large end. Measure that distance across the width of the insulation and mark it down the length of the Spiracoustic Plus. At this point, you will need to cut wedges out of the material. In order to determine how many wedges your reducer requires, subtract the circumference of the smaller end of the reducer from the circumference of the larger end of the reducer, then multiply the output by 2. For example, if you have a reducer with a 24-inch large end and a 20-inch small end, then the difference in the circumference of each end is 4 inches. Multiply 4 by 2, and you now know that your reducer needs 8 wedges cut out. Divide the circumference by 8 to determine how far apart to place the cuts. The cuts for the wedges on small diameter, SD, and very small diameter, VSD, ducts, should start approximately 3/4 of an inch on either side of the kerf. On large diameter, LD, ducts, the wedge cuts should start approximately 1.5 inches on either side of the kerf. In this case, we are working with an SD reducer, and as such, each cut will start 3/4 of an inch to either side of the kerf. The cut should angle in toward the kerf so that the wide end of the wedge is at the edge of the Spiracoustic Plus. Do not place any cuts at either end of the insulation. Use a straight edge, like a ruler or the edge of a table, to gently bend the wedge sections inward. Be careful not to buckle the material completely. Next, roll the Spiracoustic Plus together just as you would a straight section, adhering the edges together with tape, starting at the end farthest away from the wedges. Now fold the wedges together one at a time, using a small piece of tape to tape the seam perpendicularly across the top, then move on to the next wedge. Once all the wedges are taped together at the top, go around a second time, taping the seams from end to end longitudinally one at a time. Once this is complete, slide the reducer onto the insulation, ensuring that it fits snugly and there aren't any gaps between the insulation and the duct. Bear in mind that the unique shape of the reducer means that once the Spiracoustic Plus has been fabricated to fit a reducer, it should not be buckled to go inside the duct like it would on a straight run. It must slide in directly. At this point, you're ready to fabricate the section for the narrow end of the reducer. Simply measure from the narrow taper seam to the edge of the narrow end, and then add 2 to 3 inches to that measurement. Using that measurement, cut the insulation to fit the depth and circumference of the narrow end of the reducer. Roll the insulation into the appropriate circular shape, taping the seam together just as you would a straight section of pipe. Buckle the insulation into a heart shape, place it into the narrow end of the reducer, and let it snap into place, just like you would on a straight run. Trim off the excess material at both ends, and then seal the joints in the insulation with Super Seal. Another common fitting that installers must navigate is a T. Many fabricators and installers have a template that enables them to make the appropriate cuts on Spiracoustic Plus. However, if you do not have such a template, You can use the following method to install Spiracoustic Plus into a T fitting. First, measure the circumference of the duct and cut the appropriate length to line the duct with Spiracoustic Plus. Then, roll the material as you would for a straight duct. Slide the insulation into the smaller branch that extends from the T, pushing it past the intersection so that it almost touches the opposite side of the duct. For very small diameter and small diameter ducts, the material should slide into the duct. For large diameter ducts, the material can be folded into a heart shape and placed into the duct. Once released, the material should pop into place. Use the inside of the duct as a guide to trace the wave shape of the intersection. You will then use this line as your guide to cut the material. Remove the insulation from the T and trim the Spiracoustic Plus along the trace line. Next, place the Spiracoustic Plus into the cross section of the T with the uncut end going in first. Using the top edge of the duct as a guide, cut away the excess and set the insulation aside. As you did with the branch section, use the inside of the duct as a guide to mark where you should cut the material. Remove the material and cut out the marked section. During this cut, it is critical to cut at a shallow angle with the blade tilted upward. This will allow the two pieces of the insulation to sit together evenly when both are in place inside the T. Reinsert both pieces of insulation into the fitting, starting with the cross section of the T first, followed by the branch section. Ensure that all ends are butted snugly together, and coat the joint with super seal, ensuring that any gaps are well covered with the sealant. When using Spiracoustic Plus on straight runs, it's a simple matter to cut, tape, collapse, and insert. As we look at more unique fittings, the Spiracoustic Plus has the ability to be customized to fit the joint exactly. This ensures that the insulation lines the joint snugly, maximizing acoustical and thermal control while optimizing weight throughout the entire system.